Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's gonna be another life in my day. Day in my life, wow. This is Tuesday, so it's just a Tuesday. And so, of course, it's the Tuesday after President's Day, so we have 3 days of things we need to ship out today. And the first one is this Made in Italy round neck sold, solid layered thing. It was like layered by design. Anyway, it sold for $37.50 plus shipping. And so I am very happy about that. That sold on Depop. It's the only sale on Depop. So let me tell you what sold on Poshmark. I almost said soft surroundings. That's weird. And then I'll tell you what sold on eBay. So what sold on Poshmark are these Thursday boot company. They sold for $80. So I made a pretty good, I doubled my money, a little over double my money, which is fine. Anyway, I picked those up at a thrift store, probably shouldn't have done that, whatever. So Spider Men's gray foremost mock neck full zip jacket, that sold for $45. I sold this vintage Royal Hawaiian Creations Aloha 2X shirt that sold for $24. I sold this Orvis khaki beige core barn jacket that sold for $38. I sold this Love Stitch cream ruffle dress for $30. I sold this large square plaid floral paisley scarf for $17. And I sold this Doki Geki midnight women's blazer for $27. And 11Z's Anthropology. It's old. I don't think 11Z's has been sold at Anthropology in several years. Anyway, it's a black jumpsuit. It was a size 4, so tiny. And that sold for $20. Which I am not sad about sales. It's been a little slow, so, you know, having sales is good. Okay, so I sold these J. Crew Women size 16 City Fit 100% linen pants for $23.99 plus shipping, and that went to an international buyer. I sold this Calvin Klein dress. It was a size 6 in navy blue, and it sold it for $31.50 plus shipping. I sold this Guess by Marciano rare vintage oiled coat jacket for $35 plus shipping. I sold this Buckle BKA Peyton jeans for $17.33 plus shipping. I sold this Dancing Gecko Hawaiian black short sleeve short dress, basically. It was a size small, I think. Is it? I have no idea. Anyway, size medium. I was like, it's not in there. Sold it for $19.99 plus shipping. I sold this Pendleton Canyon shirt 2XL for $75 plus shipping. I sold this Gap long and lean gray mid-rise flare jeans for $27.99 plus shipping. And this sold pretty fast. I was actually pretty happy about this. This is the We the Free People Arden oversized tunic. Remember I showed that in a haul not that long ago? And I was like, oh, maybe I'll wear it. Yeah, I figured out that the arms are way too small for my arms. No! So it did not fit me. Otherwise, it would have fit me. So I sold it for $31.99. plus shipping. So there's our sales. I'm going to package them up and then I'm going to take you to the post office. What else am I going to do? I know I have to go to the grocery store, but I'm not sure if I'm going to bring you there because I don't think you care what I'm going to buy. I'm probably going to make a small trip to the bins. I'm going to go to Cassandra's closet and I want, still call it Clarissa's. I put it in my listing software, the things I pulled to give to them to sell for me, and yeah, I had to change it all. Anyway, so I'm gonna go there and we'll see. I might look around there. I don't have any credit yet, but I need to start getting out some of these bulky jackets so I can bring it there. Anyway, see you in a bit. Okay, we are packed and ready to go to the post office. Well, we have stuff for Value Village in the backpack. In the back seat, we have stuff for Cassandra's closet, USPS. while they were checking out my bags, I went over to the dress section, and because I'm really looking for summer dresses for summer, but I don't have a ton of dresses and I need to really kind of stock up for spring and summer. But there was a lot of, I didn't get any dresses in the end, but there was a lot of like lower end stuff that I just didn't want, or Lane Bryant. There were some things that were Lane Bryant. Either they were just too expensive for me to buy for resale, or they weren't what I wanted to sell. You know what I mean? But there was a Calvin Klein dress I think I should have picked up. I think it was $7. And it was a linen rayon mix. Now, if it was completely linen, I probably would have picked it up. I did like this romper by, Lane Bryant. It was cute and it was new tag, but it was like $32 or something like that, $22, and I did not want to spend that on there. If it was my size and I could have fit it, maybe, I don't know. But anyway, I just, like I said, I didn't end up getting any of the dresses, but some of them were cute. Like the City Chic one was cool, but I think it was too expensive for right now. But it's good to look around and see what you might want. Maybe if they'll price drop it, if it doesn't sell at full price. Oh, there's a dress I sold to them. So, well, they're going to sell for me. They don't buy straight out from you. But, yeah, I don't know why I even looked at the tag. I knew it was the dress I gave them, but it's funny. Anyway, let's see what I actually did pick up. Oh, there's this Calvin Klein dress. I think I should have got it. It's a midi dress and it did have the thing. Maybe I'll go back. It's $7. I might go back. We'll see. It is an extra large. Tell me in the comments below if you think I should have picked it up. Maybe by then I already have. Well, Second Stop is dropping some things for donation off at Value Village. I like this location because it's easier to get to and just kind of pull up and drive away. This is on Evergreen Way in Everett, if you're curious. Anyway, and then I get my 20% coupon, which I tried to show you and kind of fail. Next is the post office, and this was in the one that's in South Everett. It's a different one than I took you last time. Of course, the best part of any day is going to the bins at the end of the day. I actually prefer going at the end of the day now because A, there's more parking and there's way less people than normal. I went on a Saturday morning and it was so busy. All the carts were gone. It was just not great. So here they're doing a rotation, and I usually never go to the rotated bins when they first come out because I don't want to deal with those people and people, you know, wanting to go quickly, and that way I can just kind of go at my own leisure, you know? Okay. So I got a few things to show you. I went to the bins, as you may have seen by now. I also went to a clerk's closet. I didn't show you in great detail though. So this is the J. Crew schoolboy size 12 blazer, and this goes for a bit. So I'm really excited about this. And these J. Crew shoes, which are brand new. They look like they haven't been worn, at least not much. And yeah, so these are my size. So they don't fit me, or if I don't feel like they're comfortable, I'm gonna wear them a little bit, then I'll just sell them. All right, so this is what I found in the bins. So this is Lululemon, but it doesn't have the little tag on the inside. But you can see from the coat, you can see the Lululemon logo. And then on the back, it has it as well. And I think it's gonna be easy to figure out what style this is. And it's probably a small medium. My mannequin's a small medium, so I judge by fitting her. And then I look at Lululemon's website and they have a size chart. I compare my measurements to their size chart. I usually include the size chart in my listing and tell people to look at that and look at my measurements. And that's how I derived. This is Everest. This is such a cute, like, mini skirt. Like, it's a 100% wool mini skirt, but I love this pattern. It's a little tiny bit of pilling. Not much though. And then that's the back, which is, you know. Okay, so I picked up this
Abercrombie and Fitch. This is a men's size, 38-32, and I think these are straight. I don't know. Oh yeah, it's the Vintage Stretch 90 Slim. So yeah, these are in great condition. And I've heard that the A&F, because I can't really say it, Abercrombie and Fitch men's jeans do better than the women's, which I believe it. So, put that back on there. Okay, I'm gonna try these. I don't usually, this is Bonobos, Mrs. Monday. These are just some navy blue pants. So I thought I'd try them. These are just straight leg. And they're a size, they're a bigger size. They're a 40-34. All right, so I found this, which I do like Orvis. Orvis is a pretty solid brand. This is a large. So this is a shacket, but I do believe it's men's. Anyway, it almost fits me, but it does have pockets on the side, pockets on the chest area. Like if this was an extra large, it would totally fit me. Okay, so I'll save that for last because that one's really good. Okay, so this one is Jane and Delancey. This is new a tag, and it's a nice like striped short sleeve button up shirt. So I thought this was a good idea to get. Look how cute that back is. Okay, so then I found this. This is Jacques, but I usually don't pick up this brand. It's an extra large. I believe it's men's. Yeah. Oh yeah, because it almost fits me. Anyway, it has pockets on the side, but look at this tribal. I'm gonna walk away. I love it. I love this tribal pattern. I'm a sucker for tribal patterns, and a lot of people love them. So Southwestern, you know, whatever you want to call it. And this is the find of the day. So I need to fix her. Need to fix this because it's, you know, coming off. But this is Alpaca Connection, made in Peru. 100% alpaca. I did not find any issues with it. Oh. Don't tell me, it almost fits me, but not quite. But I mean, look how beautiful this is. I love the hearts. Love it. I didn't find any holes on it. It has some pilling, which is easy to take care of. And yeah, that's my little mini haul for today.
Thank you so much for watching. What Sold Wednesday will be on Friday instead. And I do mean Friday for real. Thank you so, so much for watching. And if you're new, please subscribe and give me a like if you enjoyed this video. Thank you again.